So, SA8000. SA8000 is created by an organization called SAI, which means Social Accountability International. It was established in 1997, and their headquarters are in New York. It's basically a multi-stakeholder initiative, and SAI produced this standard called SA8000. It's currently the leading standard from a certification point of view. It's a social certification. It analyzes companies based on 8 sectors. These sectors are go from forced labor to child labor, discrimination, freedom of association. It does not include environmental aspects. It just includes social aspects. And there's a 9th section, which regards managing systems, which are crucial for the implementation of SA8000. So basically what happens when a company wishes to certify itself, they can contact SAI. Is split in 2 entities, basically. Social Accountability International is the provider of the standard SA8000. Then there's SAS, Social Accountability Accreditation Systems, because to be certified SA8000, you have to contact what they call certification bodies, or CBs. CBs are private organizations which are accredited by SAS, and they are authorized to conduct or perform audits, control audits on organizations and institutions that wish to certify themselves. So if, once you've contacted an authorized CB, and this CB has conducted the necessary audits on your company or organization, you can then claim certification, SA8000 certification. Of course, you have to be in compliance with all the various requirements of the standard. So, Miguel was asking me, how can this help with the supply chain? Well, as Mr. DeYoung first said, many of the things I would have said as well, certifications today and standardization certifications today are crucial, and they're already present in many countries. let's not think only about countries where trade unions are already very developed. For example, Italy. I'm Italian, I'm talking about Italy. Italy is one of the countries with the highest number of certification, SA8000 certifications already. Why? Because it was easy for them to sort of obtain the certification, because they did not have to work very hard for it, because the standards were already pretty high, and so they were already in compliance with the SA8000 standard. But SA8000 is a standard that's about to be applied worldwide, also in countries where there is no trade union at all. And in those countries, certifications such as SA8000 can, of course, improve working conditions and both in the workplace and on the workers themselves. So concerning the supply chain, there is no obligation to certify the supply chain. And of course, it's one of the hardest points in general. It's always very difficult to identify the companies that are part of the supply chain, because companies usually do not want to reveal their suppliers. And furthermore, supply chain subjects are companies of their own, so the client does not have all that. I mean, they have the power through the way they ask for they ask the production of goods to their suppliers, but they can't directly influence. So to answer your question on the suppliers, it is the big question. Every single meeting, when I say it doesn't, there's this discussion on the supply chain and suppliers. So I'm not sure I have an answer on that.
Grazie a tutti.